We were actually up here in September doing some test drives here in Seattle, and I had a couple people who asked if we could take the flag off of the back because that was so loud.
It's a green boater, and we are at the Seattle Boat Show. So I'm here with Veronica from Candela, and we're going to have a little conversation about this beautiful boat that's behind us. Let's talk about the company. Where's the company based, and how did it come to North America?
Candela's actually been around for almost 10 years. We're about to celebrate our 10th anniversary this year. But it's based in Stockholm, Sweden. Founder is Swedish, lives in the Swedish archipelago, is a naval architect, really came from that side of the boating industry. They started the company kind of with the idea in mind that there had to be a better way to build boats. So the story that we always like to tell is that, you know, he used to take his kids for an ice cream at the fuel dock in the summers. It's about a 20-minute boat ride, and he was realizing that it was taking him $50 in gas for that $5
for one ice cream.
And he was like, there's got to be a better way. Being the naval architect that he was, kind of started to think about solar panels and think about electric boats, and then naturally came to the conclusion of hydrofoils, because when you're building an electric boat, it just takes a lot of energy to push something through the water. So if you're able to get that whole boat out of the water, you have a lot more efficiency. So he started the company in 2014. We produced our first model in 2019. Took him about 3 years to figure out how to make the thing fly, and another year to figure out how to make it turn. We're working on our P12, which is a big shuttle ferry.
You have driven this boat.
Yes.
And I've seen videos over there.
Oh,
and
yeah,
we're going to show some of those. So talk us through that experience.
I've been working for the company for about 2 years. So I've gotten to be around the product a lot. This specific boat is based in San Francisco. Being able to, you know, take potential customers out, take media out, all sorts of people that are interested in such an interesting and kind of new product, and get to drive them around the bay and show them what it's like to be flying above the waves. And, you know, you can chat like this at 22 knots. We were actually up here in September doing some test drives here in Seattle, and I had a couple people who asked if we could take the flag off of the back because that was so loud in comparison to everything else that it was ruining the experience. Yeah,
okay, well, let's talk about the boat a little bit. It sits in the water when it's not on foil, so you can maneuver it into dock, so it handles traditionally like a normal boat?
Exactly. Yeah, so this is our C8, so it's a 28-foot. When you're not up on the foils, it's pretty much just like a normal boat. You know, you do have to account for the foils themselves, so those have four different retractions modes, which kind of gives you that ability to either be out and foiling or to use it in a shallow area. Mm-hmm. You can trailer the boat just like you would a normal boat.
I took a walk around, the foils come right up.
Yeah.
So they're completely retractable.
Exactly.
And look at the hull, you go, where are the foils?
Exactly. And that's also to help with growth. So, you know, if you're leaving it in the harbor, you're not going to get as much growth on them.
Yeah.
And then, you know, once you're in foiling mode and you get up to 16 knots, the boat automatically takes off. So you're not doing anything except pushing that throttle forward, and then it takes off and you can kind of even it out and cruise.
Well, you've got this video that's playing over there where you've got a traditional boat, a monohull, just banging away.
Exactly.
And then you guys are beside there, like, I think you're drinking champagne or something. Like.
Yep. Really early on, actually, we did a video where we put like a wine glass on the front of the hull and went out foiling, and, you know, there's no splashing or anything like that. So it's definitely a different experience.
Let's talk about performance. So the traditional questions, and we can find this, it'll be in the show notes, links to all the specs, but in terms of just its speed, the time that you can be at full or half speed, and then recharging.
So this boat has, we use a Polestar 2 battery, it's an electric car company. It's a 69 kilowatt hour battery, and that gives us 57 nautical miles at 22 knots. So 22 knots is your cruising speed. Mm-hmm. That's where you're going to be most of the time. The boat does go up to about 30, but your best consumption is there at 22. Mm-hmm. The recharge depends on what you have available. We kind of tow the difference between the current infrastructure and what's going to be available in the future. So you can charge it on a 30 amp, a 50 amp, normal shore power, or go for a DC quick charger.
Okay.
A 50 amp, 0 to 100%, normally takes us about 6 hours.
Mm-hmm.
The DC quick charger is going to be 45 minutes.
Okay.
So that'll be quite cool when those become more and more.
It's interesting, other than, you know, electric cars, mm-hmm. They have to build all the EV stations. We've got them at the docks already.
Exactly.
Just have to get the higher charging ones.
Exactly, definitely. And there's a lot of companies working on that, you know.
Yeah.
They normally coordinate with all of us different electric boat companies and strategically put them in places where, you know, we've got customers who want to use them.
Yeah.
So, you know, we're starting to see them go in places. We've got one at our home marina in San Francisco. There's a handful, you know, all around California and Florida, and we're starting to see them up here in the Pacific Northwest as well.
Is the rest of the boat Pacific and unique to Candela? There, it's the hull design, the deck design, the instrumentation, controls, the motor, foils, that's all yours.
Yeah, we've done almost everything in-house, and we manufacture almost everything in-house as well. So a lot of it is our own design, our own technology. You know, we are kind of starting from scratch. We're the first electric hydrofoil in the world. So we really kind of had to pave our own path on that. So that's why it took us like a good handful of years to get through that R&D phase and into producing something, is because we really didn't have anyone else to follow.
Let's talk about the foils themselves. So in the Pacific Northwest, probably like any coastal region, there's always stuff floating in the water. What happens when you hit something?
Yeah, I always like to talk about it kind of in three parts, which is that, you know, the first, if you're hitting something small, smaller logs, things like that, there's a possibility they just, you know, you go straight through them, not a problem. Something that's a little bit bigger that might mess with some of the adjustments that the foils are making, because those are making like manual adjustments about 100 times a second. The boat's gonna land you. So in any case, if something's going on where the boat is sensing that something's not quite correct.
So you use the term land you?
Yes.
So it actually is going to go
like
back into the water.
It'll land. Yeah, exactly.
Gotcha.
It lands smack
down. So if it senses something wrong, the foils will retract, or the boat will slow down?
The boat will slow down.
Okay.
Yeah. So the foils don't retract automatically. Mm-hmm. That's like a button on the screen.
Yep.
But you will just basically land. And then the boat will say, hey, unexpected landing. Pull it back to neutral, it'll kind of reboot itself and you'll be able to take off again. So that'll happen in any case if you're ever in, you know, some sort of situation where the boat says, hey,
something's wrong.
Yeah, exactly. And then worst case scenario, the foils are built with breaking points. So the idea there is that if you do hit something that's really massive in the water,
it's not going to sink you.
It's not going to sink you. Your passengers are going to be fine. The hull of the boat's going to be fine. In the majority of cases, you're still going to have your motor and you're able to get back wherever you're going. And then you'll have to replace the foil. But that's honestly a pretty easy repair. It's not that hard.
Are you a direct-to-consumer model or a distributor?
In the U.S. specifically, we do direct-to-consumer. Mm. Internationally, we have dealers all over the world. For the moment, here in the U.S., we're sticking pretty direct-to-consumer. Right now, we're selling stuff for delivery in spring 2025.
Mm-hmm. When people want to know more, where can they go to find out more about Candela?
So the website's a great resource. We've got a lot of information on, you know, our leisure series and our commercial series there. We've got a ton of videos from all over the world of, you know, the boats in the water and these different spaces.
Okay. And the URL is?
It should be just Candela Boats.
Okay.
So youtube.com/CandelaBoats.
And if they need to reach out to somebody in North America?
We have like a general sales email. So you can do sales.us@candela.com.
Okay.
That's a great spot to reach us at. Otherwise, you know, if you reach out through the webpage, the contact form, whatever it may be, it'll get sent our way.
Great. And we'll put all of those links in the show notes so that people can look at that stuff. Veronica, thank you so much. It's been wonderful to get this overview. And
of course, anytime.